God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him would not perish, but would have everlasting life. For the Bible says, I come that you might have life, and life more abundantly. I am here because God Almighty has sent me here. I am here because God Almighty has sent me here. I said that I am here because the Spirit of the living God is alive. The Spirit of the living God is real. The Spirit of the living God still reigns upon the throne. The same God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is alive. God is getting ready to strike the land. God is getting ready to smite this land. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but would have everlasting life. I am here because God Almighty has brought me here. I am here because God Almighty has sent me here as a divine warner and a divine prophet amongst each and every one of you under the sound of my voice. For God is getting ready to strike this land. God wants you to repent. It don't matter if your mama listening. It don't matter who has a house. It don't matter who don't have a house. Because it is written in the Bible that the houses that people have built up for themselves in the last days, God is not going to let them live in it anyway. This is not our home. This is not our land. Repent, Judah. Repent, Israel. They get ready to come remove y'all out of this whole area. God, know I know what I'm talking about. I'm not even from Tennessee. Before such thing happens, that he will first come and warn the people. And then you will know that a true God, Spirit of God, a true prophet of God has been amongst you, because signs and wonders will follow. God ain't playing. God's not playing about his people or about you. Even if I'm here for one person, even if I'm here to save one person, the Bible says, what profit is it for a man to gain the whole world, yet to lose the soul? Repent, y'all. Repent. For the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I have been anointed to preach the gospel, to heal the brokenhearted, to set at liberty all those who are bound, and to set the captives free. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but would have everlasting life. God loves y'all. When nobody else loves you, God loves you. When nobody else will be there for you, God will be there for you. When nobody else will feed you, God makes sure y'all get food. God make them people clothe y'all. God make them people do right by y'all. But what have you given to God? Where's your prayers and offerings to God? Where's your thank you to God? We don't even thank God. Will a man rob God? Yes, you have. And your tithes and offerings. You may say, well, God, I ain't got the time. Yes, you do. Yes, sir.
Just stand on the rock where Moses stood. Rock for you as a rock.
Pray that God removes that spirit of alcoholism off of him. I bind the spirit of alcohol off of him. Before this day is out, you guys will see this man laying flat on his face in this very area, because he will be so drunk under the anointing of God Almighty and he will know that a true prophet of God Almighty has been amongst him. For God says that I come that you might have life and life more abundantly. God has come to give you life, sir, even if I'm the only one here, to let you know that God is getting ready to strike the land. And ain't nothing cooler than being drunk and trying to run from a missile coming out of the sky.
Abundantly.
God is not a God that he should be mocked. Y'all will witness before this day is out, this man will be laying here in the same area on his face. Because he will be drunk in the spirit. Because God is not a God that he will be mocked. God is sick and tired of each and every one of us, actually. He's sick and tired of all of us, actually. Not one of us is, our righteousness is a filthy rags, it is written. But we cannot continue to spit abominations before the face of the God who created us and act as if nothing's going to happen to us. We can't continue to mock God and act as if it's okay. You will find this man, mark my word, laying out right here, drunk before this day is over with. And you will know that the true prophet of God has been amongst you. For God is calling each and every one of you to repentance. All y'all is lucky. All y'all real lucky. You know why? Because there's somebody here, even if it's one person, there's somebody here who got a prayer grandma. There's somebody here who got a prayer mama. Somebody here, your family member died and went to heaven and asked God to spare your life before he strikes the land. So here I am. I come to speak life into this camp before they remove all of y'all. And they coming. They coming. There's nothing I can do about it but warn you. And it's gonna happen so fast, y'all. And I'm sorry. Ain't nothing I can do. And if I had the money, I would put y'all up in a place myself. Y'all know how they treat prophets. Don't give me nothing to help myself, let alone help y'all. I ask God for what I need. God gives me breath. God gives me life. God gives me my legs to walk on. God gives me my hands to praise him. I will never be ashamed of the gospel. That's why I'm here. Walking all up and down the Bible Belt, where I've never been in my whole life, to warn y'all that a true whipping is coming to the land. A true whipping is here. And for those of you who continue to talk amongst yourselves as the prophet of God was talking and ignoring what the prophet of God is saying, judgment has hit the household first.
God has given y'all money to take care of his people, and he's not happy with the results of what y'all did with that money. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever should believe in him would not perish, but would have everlasting life. He who the Son sets free is free indeed. God delivered me from stripping. He delivered me from drugs. I was homeless. I was an alcoholic. But the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I will never be ashamed of the gospel. I'm here to tell y'all about God's love. I'm here to tell you that God loves you so much. I'm here to remind y'all of God's faithfulness to you. I don't see any other pastors around or ministers of the gospel. Wait a minute. They don't even like me around preaching stuff like this because I started exposing them demons. I started exposing that they have robbed you and they have robbed God. Will a man rob God? Yes, he has. It is tithes and offerings. God is not happy at all right now. God has sent me as a divine warner amongst each and every one of you to repent. No, they don't like me. You know why? Because God says, I come that you might have life and life more abundantly. Y'all know God's light when y'all see it. You know God's light when you feel it.
and greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. I repent if I was y'all. Y'all the lucky ones. Y'all get to be under the sound of my voice. A lot of people not gonna get this warning, but y'all got the warning. God getting ready to strike this land. It's gonna be by fire. There'll be nowhere for nobody to run. And the fire will rain from the heavens. The fire will rain from the sky. They won't be able to give y'all no food. You know why? Because the money that the government's gonna give them for food for y'all, they gonna keep it for their families like they're doing now. I know y'all taking what y'all can get. But trust me, God sees it. God sees it. And God is not a God that he will be mocked. God needs y'all to repent. If y'all under the sound of my voice, y'all ain't gotta come forward, just repeat after me. Father God, I know I'm a sinner. I know you sent your son to die on the cross for my sins, God. God, please forgive me. God, forget me not when you get ready to strike this land, God. God, show me every day how to serve you. God, show me every day how to be under your covenant. God, show me every day how to be one of your chosen, God, because you said many are called, yet few chosen. And I know that God has come to save each and every one of you. If you said that prayer and you're under the sound of my voice, you have to believe it in your heart that he who the Son sets free is free indeed. Now go and sin no more, saith the Lord. For God so loved the world that he sent me here because he loved y'all. Because I love y'all. Well, if nobody else is here to tell you that God loves you, I'm here to remind you of God's love. I'm here to remind you that God sent his son to die for you. I'm here to remind you that our God is not a God of statues. We ain't got to burn incense to God. We ain't got to go to the pastor to ask the pastor. We can talk to God every day for ourselves.
What type of relationship are you building with me, says God Almighty? Where's your individual relationship?
You'll make sure you get that weed. You'll make sure you get that head. You'll make sure you get that alcohol. But where is your offering before the living God? Before the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob? Where's your offering to the God who brought our ancestors out of the lands of Egypt? Tennessee got a whole lot of fancy houses. They got a whole lot of fancy houses here. Who want to go to heaven? And they already in their little heavenly fancy houses. They not going to live in them. They gonna burn, y'all. All the churches gonna burn, too. The doors of the churches will be open 24 hours very soon. But once the doors are open for 24 hours, it will be too late. God says, seek my face now. What still may be found? God says he come. He sent his son into the world to die for you and me. Please don't forget about God. And I don't mean them statue gods and them demigods and them burning bell altar gods. I ain't talking about Obatala or Oshun or Shango. I ain't talking about them or Lakshmi. I'm talking about the same God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So don't get it miscombobulated. My God is real. My God reigns. My God is the only God that has the keys to the bottomless pit. There is a such place as weeping and gnashing of teeth. There is a such place for each and every one of you that are seeking the soothsayer, that's seeking the tarot card reader. Guess what? I was a tarot card reader, making $250,000 a year, living on a fancy skyriser in Chicago. But God says, come out of her. What profit is it for a man to gain the whole world, yet to lose his soul? Y'all should be asking this tarot card reader, what is she seeing in the stars? Now,
lady giving his messages to his people. Repent, y'all. God is getting ready to strike the land. And on my way to heaven, I had to stop by to remind y'all that God is real. God still reigns. God is on the throne. God ain't playing. God loves y'all. He loves you, mama. In the name of the Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, he loves you, baby. Yes. Yes.
Father, I worship your name, God. May those who have ears to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. May those who have eyes to see what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. For the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I have been anointed to preach the gospel, to set up the altars of the town, to heal the brokenhearted, and to set the captives free.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but would have everlasting life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him would not perish, but would have everlasting life. He who the Son sets free is free indeed. For the Bible says, what profit is it for a man to gain the whole world, yet to lose his soul? Repent, y'all. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. For God is sending his prophets out the street. To warn, just like in the days of Noah, y'all. They laughed at Noah. When Noah was building the ark, they laughed at Noah. They didn't think the flood was coming. I'm trying to tell y'all, the flood is here. Get on the boat. For God so loved the world that he gave his Son for me and you, so that you will live, y'all. This ain't no joke. You are literally being visited by heaven. And y'all don't even know it. I ain't got no fancy equipment. I ain't got no flashing lights. I ain't got no marching band behind me, except the angels of heaven that y'all can't even see. Y'all so distracted by y'all temporary entertainment on the way to hell in a handbasket, dressed up or messed up. There's a place in the bottomless pit for children as well. I didn't know children could go to hell. Yeah, children can go to hell. Because if you don't repent, your children will be next to you in hell. Because God has given you a chance to repent. I am shouting to the rooftop because I will never be ashamed of the gospel. To your shouting comment. How about that? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him would not perish, but would have everlasting life. Whoever mocked me, whoever said something, judgment has to get in your household first.
Greater is he that is in the world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Then he died for me. He died for you. This ain't no joke. Y'all know it ain't no joke. Y'all the lucky. Y'all the lucky ones. I said y'all the lucky ones. Nobody came to tell me how much God loved me. Nobody came to help me. I love you too, babe. But God sent me here as a divine warner. To warn y'all, to repent. God is getting ready to strike this land. I saw it, y'all. It was missiles, nuclear missiles, coming out the sky. The water is drying up, y'all. The Euphrates River is dried up. Did they tell y'all that? It's in the Bible. The
Euphrates River is dried up, bro. Please repent. Please repent, bro. Please. Please, yes, y'all, repent. Yes, repent. This ain't no joke. This ain't no test of the emergency broadcast system. This is a real deal, baby. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. I am here because God Almighty brought me here. I am here amongst you under the sound of my voice because God Almighty has sent me here. God orders my steps, not man. I will never be ashamed of the gospel. For greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Repent, y'all. God will bring you out of your situation, sis. Repent. Repent. Stay close to him, and God will bring you out. Watch. I'm trying to tell you, if you're not sleeping with that woman, if you're sleeping with that man, I'm telling you, ain't nothing worth my soul. Ain't nothing. I would not be playing with God at all. What profit is it for temporary sexual sin to satisfy you, for you to be spinning eternally in a bottomless pit? Repent. I repent. I repent because y'all on the way to hell in a handbasket. I ain't going down with the devil. And I highly recommend y'all don't go down with the devil either. I come to bring life, to speak life, to remind you that the same God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob reigns. He reigns. He still reigns. God reigns, y'all. God is alive. He's still on the throne. It's no joke. He's going to strike the land. I'm a warner. I ain't going to have your blood on my hands. I warned them, God. I told them, God. I told them, God. I'm not going to have their blood on my hands. So God says, choose you this day who you will serve. Choose you this day who you will serve, saith the Lord. On my way to heaven. I said, on my way to heaven. I came to remind y'all that the one true living God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob still holds the keys to the bottomless pit. And he's coming, y'all. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Amen.